when you attack Speaker, you have attacked all of us, you have attacked the whole of Busoga, and this is not an issue of just Parliament. We see something beyond this, and we pray that the two arms of government come to an agreement.
This one is turning out to be a war between the President and the Speaker. But when we look at what everyone is supposed to do, you find that we are all doing the same thing. We are fighting COVID. When we are fighting COVID and we are using different approaches, we find ourselves in a situation where one wants to outshine the other. We are the members of Parliament and we are the people who are dealing with our communities day in, day out.
Members of Parliament are shock absorbers. Everyone knows that most of the institutions, government institutions, have collapsed. And it is members of Parliament shouldering government work. So when we come out to take on the responsibility of government, where government has failed.
The 20 million they gave us are still there on our account. We don't need the directive of the president to tell us that he will do this and this and this. Let Parliament come out with a position, will refund his money. After all, that has been the president's habit of bribing MPs.
I therefore want to call upon my colleagues in Parliament to come up like the way we, the Basogas, have come up, to defend our institution, to defend what Parliament is supposed to do, and to advise where necessary.